Is it visible, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. So, good morning, you all. So, today I'm going to talk about the wearable and the flexible antennas, particularly next generation applications of wearable and the flexible antennas. Actually, this is a unique topic as well as this is the future topic, flexible, particularly flexible materials. Actually, what is the difference between the conventional antennas and flexible antennas means mainly the materials. Even three, like normally the microstrip antenna is having three layers like a ground plane, dielectric and the conductor. But a conventional all are like non-flexible, like all FR4 and other RT2RAD R materials. But here in flexible, all the materials, all three layers are flexible materials are used. And also nowadays, and these are the outline. Actually, the availability of a high speed, massive capacity, as well as low latency 5G networks is has enabled for the future generation applications. And also for particularly for the 5G networks, the ranging of 3D imaging advanced, particularly in the healthcare streaming services, then smart cities. For many applications, these 5G networks are used. There, we need the flexible devices are required. So that's why we are mainly focusing on this topic. Even not only that, even for the next generation IoT related devices, is particularly inflexibility. So we need flexible components. So that's why we are moving towards this flexible materials, and particularly for the wearable applications as well as many other applications like IoTs and 5G networks, all those things. And also these are the market of this particular device. The revenue is estimated to be $30 billion US dollars in 2017 and $300 billion US dollars in 2028. So demand of this flexible materials. Even the markets for flexible wireless devices are rapidly increasing every year, and partly due to the demands in wearable and implantable devices for particularly for the health monitoring systems and daily life wireless devices. Many devices like cell phones and laptops, computers. For all these reasons, the need of flexible printed antennas has increased demand in recent years. And also, especially in biomedical applications also, these flexible materials, whenever we are using for the chest and arm, for all those things, the bending devices are required. So for bending, these flexible materials or flexible antennas are required. Specifically, these flexible antennas are a major component in the implementation in particularly vivo monitoring of vital signs and regulations of organ functions and neural interfaces and continuous gait analysis and intracranial sensors, even drug delivery systems and some of these countless other functions also in biomedical applications. And even for the integrating many other devices into human body, that is a very difficult task actually. So because of this flexible materials, we can easily bend the stiffness of the thin film structures, the characteristics of this bending deformation regularly scales with this using these materials. Apart from the biomedical applications, there is interest between the federal agencies, industries, and academia developing in flexible antennas for extreme conditions. Federal agencies, like the applications are for high temperature flexible devices, including the new gas cooled nuclear reactor and other things we need. And also Department of Defense also, the communication solutions beyond line of sight communications in on a small to medium scale unmanned aircraft systems, they need these flexible antennas or flexible devices. And also several recent investigations also said that this the fabrication, the particularly this material aspect and the applications of different flexible and wearable antennas are available in many places, and practical guidelines for these devices, particularly for fabricating these non-textile and the fully textile wearable antennas, has been reported in many literatures, and many universities are doing a lot of research in this particular topic for the next generation networks. And also different fabrication technologies for flexible antennas with the analysis of printed monopole antennas also it's here. The mainly we can discuss with the materials in flexible antennas. Here it is showing this wearable antennas for wireless applications. You can see this is the human, the ISM band, no, particularly the industrial scientific band. It starts from 2.45, then 5.2, 5.8, then mixed band also. Mixed band is 408 to 412 megahertz. So all these things are needed for the biomedical applications. And even in the code itself, we can wear all these wearable antennas, like for GPS antennas, then accelerometers, then the data recording, processing, transmission, and then flexible batteries can be mounted, and then textile antennas also is mounted in this. So these are all these flexible materials for that is wearable antenna applications for wireless thing. Actually, the flexible antennas are fabricated using various conductive materials and substrates. Particularly, the substrate is chosen based on their dielectric properties, then tolerance to mechanical deformation. Particularly, I already said the bending, twisting, and wrapping, all those properties are needed for these flexible materials. Then susceptibility to miniaturization, particularly for the biomedical and all, we need the mantra of the device are required very small size, that is miniaturization, and endurance in the external environment also. So these are all these and also we need the efficient radiation also is required for the many applications. So that's why we are going for this flexible. And these are the scope of flexible antennas. You can see here, you can particularly for this textiles, and then electronic tags, then intelligent smart cards, and then solid state lighting, and photovoltaic cells, and then X-ray imaging, then flexible electronics, even in the foils also nowadays, very small foils. They are using this flexible materials or flexible devices like that. So many scopes of this flexible antennas for the better installation. And then particularly these are the lightweight and strong, conformal, robust, and it can be optically transparent. So nowadays the optically transparent antennas also developing through researchers, a lot of literature is available, optical transparent antennas, particularly for using these flexible materials. So for that, they are using this material like Xyloguard, that is 184 PDMS based material they are using. And most importantly, it can withstand mechanical strain up to some extent. Even some cases, we can use even these conductive materials also, particularly in wireless applications. The realization of conductive patterns with the superior electrical conductivity is essential for high gain and efficiency, high efficiency in bandwidth. For all those things, we need to select the good conductive materials. Also, additionally, resistance to degradation due to the mechanical deformation is another desired feature for the conductive material. Particularly nanoparticles, that is that inks like silver, copper, and often preferred for fabricating the flexible antennas due to their high electrical conductivity. suppose silver nanoparticle ink, if we are using over copper nanoparticles due to their low rate of oxide formation, and then very few investigations observed in particularly for flexible antennas based on these copper based nanoparticles. Even if, besides these nanoparticles, the electro textile materials like nickel and this aluminium plated electron materials, then the conductive fabrics, they are used for these flexible antennas, and various types of textile and non-textile conductive materials for developing these flexible antennas have been discussed in the future slides. So here you can see the considerations when designing the wearable antennas. So first we need to select the consider this parameter, specific absorption rate, that is SAR. So SAR is very, very essential for whenever we are going for this biomedical and other applications. It is the measure rate at which energy is absorbed by the human body when exposed to a radio frequency. And also normally for the 1 gram of tissues, that is the 2.4 watts of power is watts of power is for this 1 gram of tissues. There, that's a SAR value. It's 1.6 watts per kilogram for 1 gram of tissue. Is reported in FCC, Federal Communication Commission. And the European countries, they are following this International Electro Technical Commission. They are allowing the maximum SAR value of 2 watts per kilogram over 10 gram of tissue. The second, we have to concentrate on radiation health hazards. Particularly, this is the very the valuable and the very essential, particularly nowadays, due to this radiation effects. So this radiation effects of this wearable communication devices, particularly if you take in our daily life, we are using the mobile phones and most common communication device. We are very keeping very close to our body. Somebody's are keeping in their pocket, somebody's are in the pant pocket, shirt pockets, man pockets. Now, so in particularly many metropolitan cities, business people are there using 3-4 mobile phones they are keeping in their pockets. Really, it is a very dangerous to the health, because if you continuously if you're keeping the shirt pocket, so definitely the heart will get affected, and then if you're keeping the pant pockets, then kidney will get affected continuously if you are keeping. So that way, that radiation is very hazardous to the human. And also the many literatures and scientists have reported the health effects of using mobile phones, including changes in brain activity, reaction times and sleep patterns, longer usage for 15 or more years, so can cause tumors in brain or possible brain cancers. Because nowadays, apart from this pandemic, many people are affected this cell phone tower radiation effects. Knowingly or unknowingly, who are living near to the cell phone tower, less than 300 meters, so without knowing anything, they are affecting the brain cancers and blood cancers. So like that, even some people, they are not getting good sleep properly, sleep disorders, then tetanus effect, and then the liquids, no, the eye surrounding joints, that liquids will get dry, and then so many issues due to these radiation effects. So we need to take care about these things, particularly those who are all living near to the cell phone tower. Is very, very dangerous. So that important thing is bending effect. Particularly if you are using this flexible antennas for wearable applications, so we need to take care about the bending effects. Already said the materials, materials, bending materials nowadays, a lot of materials are available. Even in the RTDY itself, bending materials are nowadays available. And then PDMS, then if you want to make it a very small, thin film materials, even already said using this copper nanoparticles, then nickel nanoparticles. So these things we can use for the flexible electronics. Then flexible antennas gives the advantage of easy mounting on any part of the body because of the bending. So we have to mount any place like arm, chest or thigh or any places we can hip or any places we can mount this flexible antennas because of this bending effect. So the one of the main challenging tasks is to minimize the bending effect and antenna performance. So that is a really very high task. So too much bending could affect the antenna performance. So we can't go for the beyond the particular bending for this antenna. So such a shift in operating frequency and radiation degradations and drop in frequency effects. Then the effect of human body and antenna. So if you are keeping the antenna in the human body, so many effects due to this antenna performance and radiation. The human body have its own dielectric properties because the human skin is having different dielectric property, epsilon r, and the skin tissues having different one, and the bone is having different epsilon r values, a very high dielectric values. So each of these human body tissue take skin, bone, muscles and fat, their own dielectric values. So human body have high dielectric values than that of antenna due to which the frequency band tend to shift to lower frequencies when insult to the human body. So the radiation pattern also will be reshaped in presence of the antenna when compared to off body radiation pattern. So off body, this means the conventional antennas, so that that is a normal telnet and other figure of eight and other shapes are monopole or uni planar type of radiation patterns are available. But particularly for this human, if you consider with the human, so we have to reshape the antennas with the flexible material. Then we have to verify the radiation patterns. And also there could be degradation in the gain, and the efficiency in presence of a human body will be very less compared to the effect of body efficiency value. And the loading effects due to human body should be reduced to avoid performance degradation by isolating the antennas. So these are the examples of flexible and wearable antennas for wearable applications. You can see, so this is the first one actually. So this reference one, so this is a flexible material. So this is like a bending effect using this materials, and we can wear in the arms or the hands and thighs or many places we can wear, and we can even bend like this. And then you can see this is the flexible, and this is particularly for the RFID also we have to bend like this. And the flexible antennas are robust because of these flexible materials, and then lightweight antennas, and which are withstand a mechanical strain up to a certain extent. Here you can see this the examples and the scope of this flexible electronics. Even we can use in the aircraft, particularly because of these materials are conformable, then strong, then lightweight. So that's why very easily mount on the body of the aircraft and spacecrafts. So normally flexible antennas are four fabrication methods. One is polymer based antennas, then textile antennas, then actually these are the types of this flexible antennas: polymer based antennas, textile antennas, microfluidic antennas, then carbon based carbon nanotube antennas using these nano antennas. Actually, if you take these two, the first two is the polymer based textile is the easy fabrication, and carbon nanotube and microfluidics are difficult fabrication because of this nano fabrications are involved in this because of lack of fabrication facilities particularly in India. So it is somewhat difficult. If we have the nano fabrication facilities available in India, so we can very easily we can do. If we are going for the batch fabrication, this nano fabrication are very very less cost compared to the conventional antennas fabrication cost. So initial cost of this fabrication only very high. So once if they started all those facilities, this also will be easy fabrication. So polymer based materials are used as a substrate for these antennas, particularly the material like crystal polymers, liquid crystal polymers, then polydimethyl methyl oxane, that is called PDMS, then polyethermide PEA, polythene tele terephthalate, that is PET, then polyterephuroethylene PTF, and then PEG, polyethylene glycol. So one of the most commonly used substrate is silicon based elastomer, that is PDMS. As the PDMS, we can develop our own using these chemicals. Also, because of this low dielectric constant, low less loss tangent. So each of these polymers can made in different ways, and avail polymer substrates having different thickness and different dielectric constant due to the suitable for the different applications. The preparation of these PDMS sheets, there are different steps involved. So one is the mixing base and curing agent in suitable ratio, and degassing the air bubbles using vacuumed desiccation process, and then pouring the liquid state polymer into customized mold, then bake using hot air oven by following slow annealing, medium or rapid annealing. Then once backed with a flexible polymer sheet, can be peeled from the mold. So these are the different steps are involved to make the PDMS material. So here you can see this flexible the materials, how the polymer based antennas, we can see that is elastomer based poly dimethyl siloxane, that is a PDMS. So these are the various silicon elastomers. So using this chemical, so we can make. So this is the 30 millimeter length of this PDMS made. And then the reasons to opt for PDMS, one is it is an inexpensive flexible polymer, then it can withstand mechanical strain, and then can be mixed and poured at room temperature, then dielectric properties can be tuned. And also the PDMS ceramic composites. So polymer ceramic composites offer particularly flexibility, then low loss material. And PDMS ceramic composite substrates, so initially we have to take the chemicals, ceramic powder to PDMS, then mix under vacuum at high speed oven, and then pour a petri dish and leave for 1 day. So then peel off the petri dish, so then we can make this PDMS material. So this is the example of the patch antenna, flexible patch antenna using the PDMS ceramic substrate. So you can see. So this is the carbon nanotube based flexible antenna. So here you can see this is the single patch antenna using this carbon nanotube material. So this is the cross section of this one. And the next one is microfluidic liquids. So microfluidics also using the fabrication of micro fabrication, that is a microelectromechanical system fabrication. They are using to develop this microfluidics and liquid antennas. This is also mainly used for the biomedical applications to detect the blood level. Also, the my blood channels, we can put the blood samples, and then we can identify all those, even these viruses also, even the coronavirus also, we can detect using this type of liquid antennas. So we can put these blood samples, and then we can identify the corona virus also. So liquid metals are filled in microfluidics cavities in silicon elastomer. Then the liquid metal prevents loss of electrical connectivity when the antenna is deformed. Then liquid metal antennas, on the other hand, it can conform to any shape without the deformation. Particularly in the next one is the textile based antennas, textile based flexible. So one is Flectron, they are using as a material. Then flex fabrics, there we can mount this type of textile antennas. Then conductive textile coated with carbon nanotubes and gold, also we can use as textile materials, particularly for this flexible materials. Then other next one is the plastic antennas by metallized elastomers. So this this elastic Copeland waveguide is the structure was developed. So particularly in this case, around 0 to 7 GHz. One is at 1.8, another is around 3.5, then 5.8. So like that, all ISM bands, and then this is the another one is like ultra wide band monopole antenna. So this is a circular patch antenna was developed with these flexible materials and this elastic material. Then this is the radiation pattern of this particular this one. So this is the other examples of applications of these flexible antennas. Aircraft, aeroplane, then medicine applications, and then military applications, and then e-textiles, and then flexible RFID tags also, we can use these flexible antennas. So flexible and wearable wireless systems require the integration of antennas. We need some design requirements. One is lightweight, and second is low profile, then conformable, then robust, and then good performance. So equal with the conventional antennas. So these are the requirements of this thing to design the things. So here we developed some flexible, compact, robust, low profile, and efficient antennas. Here the performance characterization of antennas when subjected to bending and rolling effect we tried, and utilizing the proposed antennas for the particular practical applications. So these are some previous work done with the textile antennas, fluidic antennas, paper based antennas, then liquid crystal polymer antennas, LCP. So here they developed designs using the Captain polyimide substrate. The thickness, the substrate materials are low thickness, that is 50.8 micrometer, then high tensile strength 165 megapascal, and then high flexibility. So then very low loss, that is loss tangent is 0.002, then high thermal stability, then Copeland waveguide feed we used in this, then compact design and inject printing, and also multiple bands of applications we can use this antenna. So these are the fabrication methods we used. One is screen printing, then chemical etching, inject printing. These are the three methods are available. Screen printing is non-uniform, then limited resolution, then waste materials are more. Then chemical lengthy process by products, multi-step, low production. Inject printing is high resolution, additive, clean, roll-to-roll is possible in this inject printing. So what we consider, first we consider this monopole antenna. So monopole antenna, simple monopole antenna we designed with a 38 millimeter by 25 millimeter, and particularly for this 2.45 we could consider. So these are the dimensions, the length for a different one. So this length L1, L2, then L3, L4. So all this W width also, W1, W2, W3, W4, W5. Then gap between this one, G1, G2. So everything is calculated. And also this reflection coefficient is getting minus 26 dB we got. Then the here for particularly for the flexibility test, we took one a pipe. So in that rod we mount this antenna, the flexible antenna. Then we tested with the VNA, the reflection coefficient. So we got initially we tested with the flat, then bent of this radius for 10 millimeter, then 8 millimeter. Then we analyzed the reflection coefficient. So we got minus 24, minus 25, minus 27 dB. So like that, we got this one. Then these are the radiation pattern. One is the E-plane simulated and measured results of this one. So simulated is almost, it's getting very exact one. Some small variations in this measured one. So similarly, H-plane also, we got almost omnidirectional pattern we got for this monopole antenna. So we compared with this proposed single man antenna, dual man antenna, textile antenna, paper based flexible fluidic antennas, and then flexible Bote antenna. So in that we compared all those things. So and then the next ultra wide band antenna. So if you see just a finger this very very small type of antenna, so 47 millimeter by 37 millimeter. So UWB normally more advantages. It is a high data rate and low power, then simple hardware configuration, and this but only the distance coverage is less than 10 meters. And the using this UWB antennas, we need to apply for wireless PC and then multimedia connectivity and the network access for mobile computing devices, then wireless body area network WMAN applications also we can use this UWB. Why particularly for WMAN means it, so for wireless body area networks we need very high data rate, so there we can use this ultra wide band, and there it's a very high data rate, more than 10 Gbps is possible. And here we compared with the one is the tapered one, tapered this one, this feeding, and then straight feeding we use, and then we analyzed this reflection coefficient. So here we got some ultra wide, like from 2.22, around 14 or 15, we got the wide band. These are the radiation patterns. One is for the co-polarization and cross-polarization. Co means the 0 degree as well as 90 degree. We analyzed at 2.45 XZ plane, and then 5.2 also we analyzed. And this gain is almost, it is getting the maximum of close to 5 dB, dBi. Even this flexible antennas we can use for this MIMO also. So MIMO normally for the multiple input and multiple antennas we can use at both the transmitter and receiver for the improving the communication performance as well as improve the signal capacity, then latency, all and diversity also, polarization diversity is also possible. So because of this, we can use the MIMO concept particularly for this flexible, using the flexible materials. Now this is mutual coupling reduction between flexible printed monopole using bridged SRR, that is splintering resonators. So reduction of mutual, because mutual coupling effect is a very challenging task in MIMO systems. So because of this mutual coupling, it will affect the current distribution and phase, then input impedance, the radiation pattern in each antenna element, and also reduces the capacity of MIMO systems because of this mutual coupling. So if you are using the this principles, like that is a metamaterial, using the metamaterial, it is a negative ground plane, and then CSR or complementary splintering resonator, then defective ground planes or defective ground structures in the microstrip itself, then the EBG and meta surfaces also to improve these effects. Then here we proposed the design particularly for this MIMO antenna. So using this SRR, so this simple patch the wavelength is 132 millimeter. The size of this antenna is 75 millimeter by 37 millimeter, and also this one got published in Journal of Applied Computational Electromagnetics. And this is the surface current and far field radiation pattern. So this is the far field radiation pattern. The surface current effects, if you observe in this the maximum this red color is showing the maximum current around 14.2 amps. Then S parameters and envelope correlation. So this envelope correlation is also a very important parameter when we go for this UWB applications and other things. We need this by using this MIMO concept. So this is the envelope correlation. Rho is equal to the magnitude of S11 asterisk complex conjugate and S22 plus S21 into S22 whole square divided by 1 minus magnitude of S22 squared plus magnitude S22 squared into 1 minus magnitude of S22 squared plus magnitude S12 squared. So then you can see this rectangular plot, and then SAS basic absorption reduction in telemedicine systems. As telemedicine or medicine applications, so we have to reduce this SAR value, then we have to maintain already said 1.6 watts per 1 gram of human tissue. So we have to maintain that when we are using the mobile and other things, and even for the biomedical or implantable antennas also we have to take care. And so telemedicine applications, particularly post surgery, when we are doing post surgery patients recovery tracking systems, and then monitoring the body performance of astronauts and athletes, so there we have to take care of this one. And then the remote health monitoring systems, so there also we need to take care about this materials, flexible materials particularly. Mainly, so we need to concentrate on substrate materials. So because of using this flexible substrate materials, so we need to the minimal dielectric losses, then low relative permittivity, and then low coefficient of thermal expansion, and high thermal conductivity, particularly such a constraint is driven by the need for increased efficiency in different environments, particularly for the wireless or 5G or IoT or biomedical environment. So we need to, at the cost of the large antennas, and also size also is a matter of particularly for the biomedical. Even an exception on the above this size and other low weight, So large dielectric constant for miniaturized antennas. So so we need to concentrate on three types of substrates. So in the fabrication of flexible antennas, one is the thin glass, mainly for usable for the bendable property. Then thin glass, and then metal foils. Metal foils also we can use, then plastics, then polymer based substrates can be used as a flexible material. And also plastic, already said, plastic or polymer materials are the best candidate for the flexible antenna applications, mainly for the thermoplastic semi-crystalline polymers, then polyethylene PET, already said, polyethylene tetrachlorate, and also the PES, also like polyethylene sulfone. So like that, many materials we need to concentrate for developing the flexible antennas. And also more attractive materials, flexible materials of flexible antennas, particularly the robustness, then flexibility, then wettability, and stretchability also, because of this flexibility. And then artificial magnetic conductors, AMC based the antennas are already available. Then already said the Kapton polymer, particularly for the RF energy harvesting for the next generation radiation systems, we need to use this Kapton polymer materials. And then particularly for this wearable applications, we need to use this mainly for, we have to concentrate the mechanical stability and withstanding rigors, that particularly washing and ironing. So that time also we need to take care about this material. And so different types of substrates are used when we are going for the wearable type of antennas, particularly the that is particular textile materials like felt or fleece or silk or cardboard, these type of textile materials. So we need to take care, because of if we are using this PDMS, polymer based substrate, it has been the emerging because of this low Young's modulus. Because of this is very low, particularly less than 3 MPa, this PDMS devices. So that's why PDMS is more suitable for this textile based antennas particularly. And then paper substrate also already preferred for these flexible antennas. Because these paper based antennas, flexible antennas, is cost effective in nature, and in case of manufacturing also it's very easy. And then coplanar waveguide fed flexible UWB antennas already shown. So this is operating from 2.2 to 10.12 GHz, and even it can be used for the IoT applications in many other things also. Even liquid crystal polymers also is used as a flexible printed circuit, like a thin film substrate. There also we can use for the high frequency applications. And by particularly for this biomedical health care, health monitoring systems, we can use instead of this so many the conventional sensors. So in that we can replace these small type of flexible antennas. We can monitor all the organ activities, even for glucose monitoring, then DNA, then blood pressure, then ECG, EMG, all those things, toxins. So we can easily analyze with these flexible antennas. Then antennas in telemedicine, so we need to concentrate planar antennas, then compact, the compact size, then conformable, robust, and reliable, then light weight, reduced SAR, then resilient to impedance mismatch, and then so we need to choose the two things. One is a microstrip and printed dipole or monopole antennas, particularly for the telemedicine applications. Then so this is a comparison between microstrip versus printed monopole antenna. So microstrip are inherently narrow band antennas, you know, because of this the drawback of this microstrip is a narrow band. Monopole antennas are wide band antennas, so that's why it is very uniquely used for many practical applications. So here we design reliable wide band antenna with a hemispherical radiation pattern, and it is mainly for the isolate the patient's body from undesired electromagnetic radiation while keeping antenna's required characteristics. So these are the previous works actually. So this adding cavity or shielding plane, then using absorbers, then SNG material, single negative material, then textile EBG, electromagnetic electro band gap structure, electromagnetic band gap structure. Then some of the drawbacks in the previous work on is the increasing height as well as complicated in manufacturing, then decreased efficiency, and then large design steps are required for the. So here we designed with the AMC based design, so artificial magnetic conductor. So it's a simple monopole antenna. So the EBG based this things are used in this ground plane. Artificial magnetic conductors are used. So this is the reflection coefficient with the anechoic chamber. This is the VNA result that is minus 30, minus 37 for simulated and measured is and then minus with and without the AMC we used. Then radiation patterns and S parameters. So this is the radiation pattern. Then reflection coefficient. Some difference is there with the AMC and without the AMC. Then SAR can be calculated using this equation. So SAR is equal to sigma, the conductivity, and then magnitude of E square divided by rho. So SAR value must not exceed the exposure guidelines specified by the FCC, Federal Communication Commission. The maximum allowed SAR in US and Canada is 1.6 parts per kilogram, average of 1 gram of tissue. So SAR analysis, so antenna is simulated and numerical human model. So these models are available. So they, using that we can analyze with and without AMC, artificial magnetic conductor. So here with arm we can we mounted the antenna. So this is the SAR analysis for 125 milliwatts input power. The proposed antenna shows SAR value of 0.638 watts per kilogram. So while the same antenna without AMC, it is 1.88 watts per kilogram, so which is above the specified limit allowed by the FCC. So with the AMC only, it is getting a less SAR value. So this is the surface current for this monopole antenna as well as this artificial magnetic conductors. It is getting around 0.638 watts per kilogram. Here this is 1.88 without a magnetic conductor. This is with magnetic conductor. So 1.88 watts per kilogram. This is 0.638 watts per kilogram. So what are the challenges of this antenna or materials? Are the hardware the first thing is hardware centric challenges. Because of this hardware means all these materials so need not available in the market, so we have to make our own materials, we have to prepare ourselves, then interoperability, then system devices, system and device level security and data consistency, and then interface, so like that many things. Excuse me. ஹலோ சொல்லுங்க சார். சார் கொஞ்ச நேரம் நினச்சி பேசிட்டுமா, ஒரு லெக்சர் கொடுத்துட்ருக்கேன் பேசிட்டு. நான் அப்புறமா கால் பண்ணுறேன் சார், முடிச்சுட்டு. ஓகே சார், தேங்க்யூ சார். So these are the challenges like system device and system and device level security, then data consistency, interference, then invasion of privacy, then data consistency. So these are the challenges with hardware side, and then human centric challenges, one is the cost wise, and then constant monitoring of the patient and consistent performance. Then these are the challenges of antenna when using for the wireless body area network, W band applications. So first one is mainly the power requirement. Power is very challenging task. Then SAR, then signal integrity, then body is lossy, then complex medium for signal propagation, because the body because of the very high dielectric of the body, you know, like skin, muscles, tissues and bone, they have a very high dielectric, so that's why the signal that is the lossy is more compared to the other conventional type. Then distortion of radiation pattern close to the human, and then so these are the mixed band. Already said mixed band frequency 402 to 405 MHz, then ISM band 433 MHz, then 915 MHz, 2.45, then 5.8 GHz, then UWB band 3.1 to 10.6 GHz. And these are the unlicensed frequencies available in body area network or body communication. It is a mixed band ISM, then wireless MTS, then UWB. So all are given as per the Europe and US standards. Particularly for this biomedical applications, so these are the challenging tasks. One is the biocompatible materials are required. We can't use the conventional materials for the human. So what are the suitable materials we have to select, like zirconic or ceramic, like that we have to select the particular biocompatible material. Then miniaturized devices are required to implant the antenna to the human body. Then power also we have to maintain. The low power consumption is required. Then communication links between this human to the wireless like mobile, and then some other things we need to take care of the communication link. So what we did for our research work, initially we took the live pork. So we took the pork, and then we took the pork tissues with the chemicals, no? So the equivalent chemicals we took it, and then we measured first. Initially, we measured the dielectric parameters, dielectric constant of this pork tissue. So here we can see the skin, muscle, pork, all these three things we analyzed with the pork tissues, and then conductivity also. So you can see the maximum of skin is 38, then muscle is 52.7, then pork is 48.5 epsilon r. Then conductivity also, like pork is 2.06, then muscle is 1.74, then skin is 1.46. So we measured this value, and then these are the design methodologies required for first we selected the CPW is the feeding technique, because of this is more popular in air environment. Then few implantable antennas are designed, and then less dispersion, low conductor loss, then low radiation loss. The features of this CPW is wider bandwidth, then better impedance matching, then easy integration with the passive and active, then devices with the monolithic microwave integrated circuits, also MIC, very easy to integrate with active and passive components with using this CPW transmission line. So body area network using this antennas, like body area network enabling technologies, that is antennas. So these are the significant requirements. One is the performance, then form factor, legal SAR, then so this is the the design. So this is the simulation of this one. So if you see this muscles and all the epsilon is 42, very high dielectric permittivity, and then the height normal 1.8 meter human, the 34 lambda wavelength is actually, and then the RFID antenna also 3 millimeter antenna has developed. So here you can see the RFID 870 megahertz, then ISM 2.4 GHz, the UWB 6 GHz, particularly for the mesh cells we took as 11.1, and then memory requirement is 4.3 GB RAM, and then simulation time is 18 minutes, then GPU, that is the option is required for the this one. So these are the hardware requirements of this one. Then the simulation model is only as good as its material property definitions. So we consider the phantom model, voxel model, then antennas, flexible antennas. So first example considers RFID antenna. So 870 megahertz RFID slot antenna design. So why need RFID antennas? Because of the low power, low SAR, the no battery required. Then main problem is human body absorber, because it will absorb very easily with the human body. Then so we need to take care about the SAR value. So here this is the chip impedance is 15 minus J 80 ohms, and then epsilon R is 1.17, then conductivity is 2 × 10⁻⁴ sine. This is the effect of bending effect for this antenna. So here it is getting minus 20-30 dB flexion coefficient. Then this is the horizontal and vertical plane or E-plane, H-plane. Then so effect on antenna for four cases considered. One is initially only bending antennas, then antenna with the full body, then antenna with the partial part of a human body, and then antenna on a voxel body. So for this case we analyze the reflection coefficient. So the normal antenna only it is getting around 1.1, then 0.4, 0.3, like that it's getting. Then this is the far field radiation pattern. So when bent antenna only, it is getting very good. It's highly directional. So here with the homogeneous body, some it is reduction, some radiation is reduction because of the effect of the human body. Similarly here also with the voxel body, then human homogeneous body, and partial as well as full homogeneous body. This is the current distribution of this partial body and the full body also. E-plane, H-plane also. Then RFID ranges. And receiver sensitivity, it is getting minus 15 dBm, and particularly for this this case, minus 60 dBm. The maximum of 182 meter, the read range is 1 meter only. Then the SAR value is also observed. So one is for body, which body model, it is a vocal or partial body, then full body, homogeneous like that, and then antenna deformation, positioning, everything is a matter. Then this another design is ISM patch antenna. So simple patch, only the corner are truncated. So with this the 2.4 circularly polarized patch antenna can be achieved. Why we need circular polarization? Because of the reduced multipath effects in scattering rich environments. And then multiple antennas we need to do the performance of a MIMO antenna also. And then four antennas positioned around the body. So one, two are the in the arms, no, two arms, and then one chest, and then top of the head also one. So four antennas are mounted around the body. Then this is mainly for this multiple antennas. Then this is analyzed. That is getting minus minus 30, minus 35, minus 40, minus 50. So like that, all four antennas at. The realistic gain is 2.4 is around 1.45 dBi. So this is the output of MIMO. So cross polarization rate it is at 0 dB. So when the port number is 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, so four ports. So we can see this S11. One is minus 52 dB, minus 55, minus 54, minus 80 dB. Then correlation coefficient, then diversity gain. Diversity gain is almost all are common. Correlation coefficient is also common, 3.8 and 10 power minus 7. Diversity gain is 10 dB. Then the efficiency is varied. For 1 to 2 is 55%, and 1 to 3 is 60%, and 2 to 3 is 62%, and 3 to 4 is 67%. Then next example is UWB antenna for wireless body area network. So here consider the frequency is 3 to 6 GHz UWB slot antenna. So this is the slot using the CPW. Then these are this patch and in the ground plane itself it is like a square stepped ground plane is used. So mainly the UWB is for the low power, so power consumption, low power consumption we can use, and then this is the antenna performance, particularly for this frequency 3.1 to 10.6 is getting wider bandwidth. So this is for broadband far field flat antenna. So it is getting almost a very highly radiation curve. Then here we can see these are the different box. No, inside the box we have to keep the antenna. So for that we selected different dimensions. One is 200 by 200 by 200 millimeter. Then 300, 400 by 400 millimeter. Then 600 by 200 by 400 millimeter boxes are used. For different box, different mesh cells are so there. One is 52 million mesh cells. And also 18 GB RAM is required, and for the second case 184 million mesh cells, and then 52 GB RAM. And third case is a box around 280 million mesh cells, and then 72 GB RAM is required. Then this is the vertical or E-plane and H-plane, particularly at 5.65 GHz for different volumes are different box level. Then UWB antenna mainly for the fidelity. So fidelity particularly used in this FDTD, finite difference time domain analysis. So antenna in free space applications. So we can see this correlation, cross correlation as well as group delay. Then time also we can measure the nanoseconds, and then frequency in gigahertz. That is getting some good things. Then MIC based antennas. These are all the very small, electrically small antennas. So initially consider the loop antenna. So electrically coupled loop antenna was designed. So this is particularly for 403 MHz only, particularly for this. We consider skin and muscle also, with the muscle, with the skin. And this is the experimental setup for electrically coupled loop antenna. This can be used even that is a square as well as a circular loop can be used. So large circular one and then small square can be used mainly for many applications like implantable and flexible wearable antennas. And then these are the scattering parameters of circular as well as a square loop antenna. Is getting minus 10 dB, then minus 13 or minus 17 dB. Then transmission coefficient. This is the material preparation with the equivalent with the human phantom. So with that we can measure this loop antennas. So circular and square loop antennas are measured with the VNA. Then ISM band antennas. So here we designed a CPWD fed X-shaped monopole antenna particularly for this one. So this is the equivalent circuit model we analyzed. These are the numerical calculation for this different parameters, and then this is the return loss reflection coefficient. So we got minus 23-25 dB with analysis as well as simulation. This is the prototype of this fabricated antenna, monopole antenna. So this is the phantom liquid. So equivalent with this muscle skin pad. So we prepared this phantom liquid equivalent with the human model. Then this is the skin tissue phantom liquid. And then this is the measurement setup with the VNA. So we measured inside the antenna is there inside this muscle and tissue. And this is the whole setup with the chamfer. This is the reflection coefficient with the simulation pork tissue. We consider pork tissue as well as human body phantom liquid. So equivalent to with the human body also we consider. So simulation we got minus 30 and then minus 20 for pork tissue as well as human model. Then VSWR also almost it's the range is matching one two is less than two. Then this is the E-plane co-polarization and cross-polarization, H-plane co-polarization, cross-polarization. So gain is with the phantom is 15 dBA and the 0.5 dBA for with the without phantom. This is the current distribution. It's minus 0 dB. This is the comparison of these parameters like reflection coefficient, VSWR, gain, bandwidth, antenna efficiency. Then UWB antennas. So why UWB? So low power consumption, low reduction, then high immunity to multipath firing attacks, ability to penetrate the walls, then faster than Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, data rate of 450 megabits per second instead of 1 Mbps. So ultra wideband also it is known as ultra band antennas, and it is a so UWB in the frequency range from 3.1 to 10.6 GHz. So bandwidth is greater than 500 MHz. So here you can see this UWB. So in this 802.11a, particularly for this frequency range is 5.725 to 5.825 GHz. 7.5 also. Particularly used for the wireless body area network. So this is the intro of this UWB pulses like time domain behavior, then frequency domain behavior, then this is the monopole antenna like 30 mm of the size of this UWB monopole antenna. The frequency range is 3.17 to 10.56 GHz. The channel spacing is 528 MHz, then the symbol 3.2 MHz, then subcarrier 4.125 MHz. These are the requirements, omnidirectional, the small in size and then low cost, then VSWR should be less than 2, and gain less than 5 dB, and relatively constant, and the impedance matching also needed. So here the body area network, the measurements with the fabricated the Bauty antenna, particularly with the PD, then low antenna. So this is the channel impulse response. Actually, there is a the space is zero, then angle is also zero. the circle is zero, and then the another one is 1 centimeter and 2.5 centimeter considered for this hip height of this one. So this is the return loss we got. This is the button antenna. So it's a very unique antenna for UWB applications. So the Arakai chamfer we measured. So first session may be conclude with this. So here develop the flexible, compact, and wide bandwidth antennas, and three flexible antennas were presented for the technology covering the bands like ISM, WLAN, UWB, mixed bands, and then the mutual coupling between the radiating elements is decreased using BSRR structure developed in this this work, and then BSRR and then the reduction of 11.5 dB mutual coupling is achieved using the proposed MNG structure, and then the second application AIMC based conductors lower the SAR value in wearable telemedicine systems, and the SAR values are reduced by 66% more. Or the AMC eliminates the impedance mismatch caused by the human tissue's proximity. And these are the acknowledgements. My professor, as well as my ISS scholar, Dr. S. Ashok Kumar, my professor is Raghavan, senior professor retired from the Department of ECE, NIT Trichy. He was my guru and guide, as well as my philosopher, well-wisher also. And second person, Dr. S. Ashok Kumar, was my first PhD scholar. Is professor, right? He did this work mainly, particularly this wearable as well as implantable antennas. He did lot of research contributions. Now he is working in Hyderabad. So this is with Professor Palanis. Thank you for this first session. So if you have any queries, you can ask now. Then we will wind up. Well, then we will meet at 11:30. Okay, thank you.
Any queries, participants?
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, in the presentation, you have shown human body phantom liquid, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Actually, how it was prepared, sir?
Actually, different chemicals like even HCl, and then the equivalent with the muscle skin chemicals we purchased and we prepared them actually. So okay.
Second one, sir. What is the simulation tools for this designing of a flexible antenna, sir? Normal HFSS and CST.
HFSS and CST we can use, ma'am.
Because the substrate materials are very selective for flexible antennas.
Yes, so, ma'am. Yeah, because see, if you know the properties of the any material, so you can add in the library of HFSS or CST, then you can select, madam. No issue. Whatever material you can add, if you know all the properties, then they're very easy to add any material in this tools.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, so anymore.
Have you used the phantoms available in the tool, CST tool?
Actually, the human models are available in CST actually.
Yeah.
So that models we can use for the simulation, but phantoms and all we have to prepare, sir, for measurement, and at the time of measurement we have to make it, and then we have to measure.
Okay. Because you have chosen variety of antennas as like ultra wideband antennas, if you could see the range, it varies from 3 onwards to around 10.5, right?
Yes, sir.
So the models whatever are available into a CST tool that are having a specific properties.
Yes,
that
sir.
Are having specific properties, right?
Yes, sir.
And what we could say, the properties are frequency dependent.
Yes, sir.
So have you tested, have you changed the properties of the model, or you have
actually, sir, this UWB and the standard things are available in CST itself, sir. If you want to make beyond the standard frequencies, then only that problem will arise. These are all standard things are available in CST itself. UWB is available, sir, very well. The phantom models are available. That human model is available.
Human model based on the particular frequencies are available?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Any questions from the audience, from the participants?
Sir, let me know in which model, in which CST tool it is available, because I am using CST 2019, but that kind of facilities and tools are not available in 19.
No, it's in the recent one, it is very well available. So in CST, it is available. If you are using a pirated, it may not be available. If you use the original version, licensed version, it is available, very well available.
Because in the licensed version of 2070, I think it is not available.
So, but 17 is not available. So after that, it was added.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Anybody, any questions? I hope. Yeah.
Sir, any government laws that refusing us for body testing?
Any government
rules that we need to follow while testing this body area network antennas?
Government rules means already said that the SAR is we have to need to take care. No. So the power is very, very essential, because of the, if it is not following the FCC regulations, so definitely that power level will affect the human body, no? So we need to take care about SAR value. That is very, very important.
Sir, how much power we need to set for doing the simulations?
Sir, 1.6 watts per kilogram of 1 gram of tissue, sir.
That is the regulation from FCC. Right.
But yes,
while measuring the antenna parameters, how much power, input power we need to give to antenna?
Yes, sir. Input power, particularly one design is shown around 0.638 or something, but less power is required, sir. Like some milliwatts is required.
Okay. Any questions?
Sir, SAR standards for this variable flexible antennas are similar to other antennas. That means it should be less than 0.5 watt per.
Sir, SAR value?
SAR value, standard SAR value for this flexible antenna. I think it should be less than 0.5 watt per kg.
No, 0.5, sir. Already said no, 1.6 watts, sir.
1.6.
Yes, sir.
Thanks.
Sir, what are the materials that are typically used for the cabling part in the case of a MIMO deployment?
Please repeat one second, sir. I'm not.
Sir, when we go for the MIMO deployment, that is when we go to array kind of deployment of these flexible wearable antennas. What are the cabling materials, like the feeding cables? What would be the material?
So that time we need to use the probes, sir. Probes are there. So
how do we make them bio?
No, the probes are available, sir. For that small things, we need to connect through probes.
So the same manufacturing technique is used for the probes also, is it possible? Or how is it practically done?
No, they're like small, like not normal wires. It's like probe types of wires are available. So with that, we can connect, sir.
Are there any questions from the audience? I hope there are no questions. On behalf of Dr. Balwinder Singh and NITTR Chandigarh, I personally thank Professor Shanmuganatham for conducting such a wonderful session. And he has covered every minute details on materials, whatever required, even he has covered the system requirement, because we were not aware that what could be the RAM required for the meshing. Again, the variety of antennas are covered since monopole to ultra wide band, and very well elaborated the experimental setups required and experimentation conducted. I thank once again personally to Professor Shanmuganatham. Thank you very much. And our next session will start at 11:30 sharp.
Thank you, Mahesh Munde sir, and thank you, Dr. Shanmuganatham sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. We will meet at 11:30.